So one question to ask is, what can we do when we want to factor a polynomial expression? To answer this question, we have to develop some terminology. So we'll start with something called common factor. Common factor is a factor that belongs to all the different algebraic quantities being looked at. For example, if we look at 4x squared and 12, 4x squared has 2 times 2 times x times x. 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. So 1, well, 1 is a common factor for all of the objects, right? Because 1 is multiplicative identity. But we all can see 2 is a factor here and here. 4 is a factor here and here. So 1, 2, and 4 are common factors of 4x squared and 12. But 4 is the greatest common factor, the largest common factor that belongs to both of them. So let's work on concept of common factors and also greatest common factors. And just like we did with common multiples and least common multiples. Remember, 1 is always a common factor amongst any two or more polynomials. All right, so let's find common factors of the expressions below. Let's say 5a and 35. What do you think is common? Well, 5 goes into 5a. 5 is a factor of 35 also, so 5 and 1. So we can say negative 5 and negative 1 also. But for most people, they work with positive numbers. We're giving you negatives here just so you can see you can have negative factors that sometimes you have to work with. All right, let's take a look at 5a cubed b. We have 5 is a common factor between 5 and 10. What about a? Yep, so 1, 5, a, b by itself, 5a, 5b, 5ab, and then of course all the negatives can be worked in also. But common factors are going to be 1, 5, a, b, 5a, 5b, a, b, 5ab. Right, what about these two? They share a 2. So 2 or negative 2, well, 1 of course, or negative 1. So in finding least common multiple, we looked at all the factors. So every factor had to be present, and then we picked the highest power. In order to pick a common factor, we're going to have to pick factors that are common to all the expressions, and that would mean that we have to pick the lowest power. So here are two quantities, numbers or algebraic expressions, in this case, numbers. How can we find common factor? Well, first of all, look at all the prime factors involved, 2, 3, 7, and 5. Which are common? Well, 2 is common. So 2 is common, so I'm going to have a 2. And instead, what power should we pick? 4 or 12? Well, we're going to pick 4 because that's the smallest power. What about 3 to the 10 and 3 to the 4th? We're going to need 4 because that's the smaller power. And that's it because this quantity does not have a 5. And this quantity does not have a 7. So only the common prime factors and the smallest exponent. That's what will give you the greatest common factor. All right, do that one on your own. So first, just look for common factors. What are they? X plus 1 looks like, and x plus 1, power of 4 and power of 1. So we're going to have to keep power of 1. When there's no power, it's power of 1. 2x minus 3 is here, but not here, so not to worry. X to the third and x to the 12, so which one should we keep? 12 is too big, so x to the third. So x plus 1 and x to the third to multiply together is greatest common factor. So look at the difference between greatest common factor and least common multiple. Try this one on your own. There is nothing common because x plus 1, there is no x plus 1. 2x minus 3, no 2x minus 3. X to the third, no x to the third. But even if there is nothing common, 1 is always a common factor across all quantities because 1 is multiplicative identity. Don't forget that. Do these problems on your own. So let's just review a little bit of common multiples and greatest common factor. When you're looking for least common multiple, we are using all the prime factors that appear across all the objects. Whereas when we're doing greatest common factor, only the prime factors that are common across all objects. If there are no prime factors common, then one is going to be your greatest common factor. What about exponents? What exponents do you pick? In least common multiple, if you pick a prime, then you want to pick the highest exponent. And when you pick a common prime factor, you want to pick the lowest exponent. Look at the difference between least common multiple, greatest common factor. Where are we using least common multiple? We used least common multiple when you were adding rational expressions or fractions so that you could make a common denominator. Where are we going to use greatest common factor? Let's take a look at that. All right, so suppose I gave you this polynomial. Remember, our goal is to factor. We have 4a squared plus 12a. What I can do is look at the 4a squared and 12a and find the greatest common factor. So I have 4 is 2 squared, a squared is a squared. 12 is 2 squared times 3, and a is a to the power of 1. So to find greatest common factor, we're going to need a 2, and the lowest exponent is 2. So we're going to need 2 squared. We're going to need a squared and a lowest exponent is 1. Greatest common factor is going to be 4a because 2 squared times a. All right, so now we can come over here and rewrite this. How? I'm pulling out the common factor out. What goes in the parentheses is decided by greatest common factor 4a times what? Will give you 4a squared. The 4 is already here. A times what will give you a squared? That'll be an a. 4a times what gives you 12a? So 4a times 3 gives you 12a. So if you use the distributive property here, you will get this. All right, try that on your own. All right, so let's write it in a factored form, and now we want to look for a greatest common factor. So between here and here, what do you see as greatest common factor? I see a 3, a squared, b. 3a squared b is going to be the greatest common factor. So let's rewrite this. This will be 3a squared b times negative a. That's what will give me the negative, and a squared times a will give me a cubed. 3a squared b times 2 squared will give me all of that. So now I can write 3a squared b, which is my greatest common factor, times the negative a from here, and plus 2 squared, which is negative a plus 4 then. Here's another way to look at it. We can write this as negative 3a cubed b, and instead of positive 12, we make it negative 2 squared times negative 3a squared b. Because now I can write negative 3a squared b times a and minus a 2 squared, which is a 4. So that's another way to write it. So you could pull out 3a squared b, which was the greatest common factor, or you could pull out the negative of the greatest common factor and rewrite it. You just have to make sure that you adjust the sign on the inside so that when you use the distributive property, you end up with this quantity. That's what's really important. All right, let's try that on your own. Pause the video, try it. So let's factor everything and look for greatest common factor. So look over here, we have 3 and we need 3. So 3 is going to be part of the greatest common factor, a to the second power and b to the third power. So now 3a squared b to the third is the greatest common factor because those two multiply to give you a to the sixth and those two multiply to give you b to the fifth. All right, so then we're going to have that left over, which is same as 8a to the 4 minus 5b squared. Pay very careful attention on how to pull out greatest common factor. All right, try that. Now, this might remind you of something when we were adding and subtracting like terms, isn't it? x plus y was our unit, and then you added them or subtracted them. So we're going to have 4x minus 5y times x plus y. That's how we did them before. Now, x plus y is our greatest common factor, so I can pull it out and then write down times what's left over, which is 4x minus 5y. So another way of doing the same problem. All right, let's take a look at this next one. This one is a little bit tricky. We can rewrite q minus p as negative 1 times p minus q, because negative 1 times p is negative p, negative 1 times negative q is positive q. This allows us to see greatest common factor immediately. P minus q is the greatest common factor, so we're left with p times negative 1 plus q squared. Another way to write that would be p minus q, and p times negative 1 is our negative p plus the q squared. Or we could also rewrite that as p minus q times q squared minus p, because addition is commutative. All right, let's take a look at this next one. Across here, we need greatest common factor. So we're going to need 2x minus 3 and to the power of 3, because that's the lowest power, and looks like that's it. So then we're going to be left with what? We're going to need 1, 2x minus 3 from here. 5x plus 7 is left. We're going to need 3x minus 1, and all of this is already out there. Now here, what do? You're going to have to multiply those out. 2x times 5x is 10x squared. 2x times 7 is 14x. Negative 3 times 5x is negative 15x. Negative 3 times 7 is negative 21. And then just add like terms. 14x minus 15x is negative 1x. Plus 3x will give me 2x. And then negative 21 minus 1 is negative 22. And then that's your final answer. So you can see how many different things were involved here. Pulling out the greatest common factor, using the distributive property of multiplication. So many things are happening here. Make sure you understand every single step. If not, rewind, watch previous lectures, come back to it. Here's your video log. Questions to work on?